What's good, my YouTube family? This is the boy JC, home of all things tech and Asus. Okay, what I got before you today is my beloved Asus ROG Strix G15 Advantage Edition. I'm in love with this. From the first day I laid my eyes on this thing, this was the best money spent. And the thing I like about this peak gaming laptop, it is so upgradable. It's not even funny. I got 232 gigabits of RAM inside this machine, so I have a total of 64 gigabits of RAM. I got a 1 terabyte SSD Gen 3 in the available space. I'm thinking of bumping it up to 4 terabytes, but I'm doing a Wi-Fi card update. A specific viewer of my video, I don't know how to pronounce this individual's name, so I don't want to spoil it out of respect. They asked me about it because people complaining about the MediaTek Wi-Fi card that it comes with, and it, to me, it's okay, but it's kind of wonky. So what I did, I ordered a Intel AX200 Wi-Fi 6AX Wi-Fi card. So I'm going to install it in there and do a speed test, and this is it right here. This is what I got right here today. This one right here, as you can see in the back, is an Intel Wi-Fi 6 card. Wi-Fi 6 card right here. And excuse me. This is the brand I see on Amazon, OKN Wi-Fi 6. This one I ordered from Amazon. I'll leave the link in the description. This is the case that it comes in. It's very small. And it comes with a little, I think it's like a little bracket or whatever it is. It comes with a screw. That's fine. So I'm not fussy. If you know me already. So I'm gonna put this bad boy in a minute. So but I wanna show you something first. Okay, first of all, I'm gonna show you right here inside device manager the type of Wi-Fi card that's inside this gaming laptop right here. So we're going to device manager and network adapter, and now let me just scroll in for you so you guys can see. You see right here, it's a MediaTek Wi-Fi 6. So you can see for yourself, a MediaTek Wi-Fi 6. So let me come out, and now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna do a O+ speed test. Cause I'm on the Wi-Fi at home. I got a one gig service with Spectrum. I'm approximately between 70 to 80 feet away from my Wi-Fi 6 router. So I'm gonna go to Ookla speed test and do a speed test right here. So let me get it up. And like I said, I'm approximately about 70 to 80 feet away from the Wi-Fi router. So let's see what kind of speeds I get. Let's just zoom in so you can see. First thing first. Okay. So that is for the download. As you guys could see. Excuse me, sorry about that. Alright, so for down, I'm getting 109.2, and the upload, because it's not even though I get 1 gig from Spectrum, it's not fiber, so you're not gonna get blazing speed, you know. So it is what it is. So for download, I got 109 for download and 33 for upload. So as you guys can see for yourself, and like I said, I'm approximately 70 to 8 feet away from my Wi-Fi router. And my Wi-Fi is an Amplify Alien Wi-Fi 6 router. It's a powerful router, and I love it so much. So what I'm gonna do right now, I'm gonna scrap it down and put this awesome Wi-Fi 6 Wi-Fi 6 AX200 by Intel, and let's see if there's a difference. So let's get into it. All right, while I was recording earlier, something happened to my iPhone and it stopped. So as you could see, I was recording earlier and I was showing how to disattach the cables from the Wi-Fi card and the screw it off, but something happened to my phone and it just went off. No, I'm sorry for the scratch. But as you can see, the Wi-Fi card is underneath SSD 1. So you can put it there just to show as an example. When you take off the back, it's going to be underneath SSD 1, just like this. So what you're going to do is you're going to have the white cable and the black cable. The black cable is going to be attached to the main, excuse me, and the white cable is going to be attached to the aux. So you just got to just prong it up and put it to the side. And it's very simple. Now I'm going to get the Wi-Fi card out. It's a very simple process. I'm just going to just use this to assist me to push it up. Boom. And we're out. As you can see right here, this is MediaTek Wi-Fi card. Okay. And just a side note, sorry about the coughing. As a side note, when you buy a Wi-Fi card, most of the times it depends on the PC, it doesn't have the drivers in, so you're gonna have to download the drivers. And how you can do that, because this is fairly new to me, this is something I'm doing for the first time. So according to this brand that I bought, they say scan the barcode for the drivers and document. So however you gotta scan it and get it on the PC, I'm not so sure because this is fairly new to me. Or there's another option I believe you could do. If your PC or your laptop have an Ethernet, you can connect an Ethernet cable onto it, onto your PC, and then download it. I think that's another option you could use. But anyway, what I like about this bad boy right here, it comes with a screw and a little bracket just in case. I like that. And this is, it can be right here. This is your, as you can see right here, this is the Intel. Wait a minute. This thing says right here, where did I see it again? This one said it was a, oh. This package says it was an AX200. But this Intel card saying this is an AX210. So I guess this is the latest model. Okay, anyway. So let's do this real quick. I'm gonna slide this bad boy in here. And as a side note, my PC is updated to Windows 11. So slide this bad boy in just like that. Okay, so let's get the screws. And I'd advise you, if you're gonna get a screw, if you're gonna screw it, get a screwdriver, make sure you get the screwdriver to have the magnet on it, all right? So let me just get this thing all the way first. Make sure you get a screwdriver with a magnetic tip, because these screws are small and you don't want it to get lost. So let me just get the screw right here. Screw down the Wi-Fi card first before you connect the prongs on it. Oh, sorry about that. Be nice and gentle. Be nice and gentle with it. And don't overscrew it. Screw it. Once you feel like a tension, stop. You don't want to overscrew it and then mess up the thread and then the screws. So once you screw it and feel a little tension, stop. Boom, don't go any further. Now, let me go put these prongs on. They can be a little bit of a problem, but we'll see. Okay. So, let's just go on right here. Nice and easy. So you just clip on like that. Now you go right here, my friend. Gotta be gentle with this thing, you know what I'm saying? Gotta be very gentle. See, clips on like that, boom. Gonna slide this bubble into the groove, make it look nice and neat. Alright, boom, awesome, perfect. And in the process I snap one of my RGB cables. So I'm not gonna have RGB lighting all over like I used to. I'm very upset. Anyway, like I said, everything is out of my own damn pocket anyway. So if I break it, I bought it. I'm not sponsored by nobody but myself. Now let's put back this SSD back in the slot. And then let me go use my magnetic screwdriver. Get the screws in, because like I said, these screws are very small. They're gonna be very, very gentle. You have successfully installed a Wi-Fi card inside your Asus ROG Strike G15. Now, I'm gonna unscrew this bad boy up, and we're gonna power it up and see what happens. All right, check this out. Okay, I just boot up my PC, and I didn't have to download any driver. It's already connected to the Wi-Fi in my apartment. And like I said earlier in my video, I'm approximately 70 to 80 feet away, which is kind of crazy. And according to the case, it says I got a Wi-Fi 6AX200. All right, so let's see what we got right here. So let's go into device management. Device manager, I should say. And go into network adapters. And wait a minute, this is kind of weird. Look at this. This thing says I ordered a Wi-Fi 6AX200. Now this one right here says I got a Wi-Fi 6E2100 160 megahertz. I did not expect that. So I got something more than what I ordered. Am I mad? No, I ain't mad. I'm excited. I got something more potent. So here's what I'm gonna do. Let me click it real quick. Okay, this is it right here. Wi-Fi 6E AX210. Going to advanced. Let's see what advanced says. Sorry about that. You show right here all the properties. The ABG, and you got the ACE and AC AX wireless, and you got down the channels. You got 2.4 gigahertz, 5 gigahertz, and 6 gigahertz channel. That is crazy. And all the bands right here. That is crazy. And let me see driver. Click the driver. See what it's about driver. It says right here, you got an Intel Wi-Fi 6 AX210 160 megahertz. And driver date 9/7/2020. The update driver. Update the driver for this device. And let me just go ahead and update the driver, see if there's any difference. Okay. Sometimes these things need to get a little update. I'm not so sure. Let me go right in here. Advanced driver. Update driver. This device. So it's going to search to see if there's anything. Windows will search your computer for the best available driver and install it to your device. Let's see if we can do that. It's searching. So they're saying Windows have determined that the best driver for the device is already installed. There may be better drivers on a Windows update or on the device manufacturer website. Okay, let's search for update drivers on Windows update. Let's see if there's anything there. Okay, so let's do this. Intel Core Bluetooth, so it's pending. So let's install, see what happens. You never know. So let's hit restart. Let's see what happens. Always good when you get new things to do updates, because you never know. Hey, the fan blowing, that thing is working hard. Alright. Let's see if there's any updates available. Go back in here. Check in Windows. So it's doing this download so far. Well, so far, it's pretty much plug and play. I really like this. You plug it in, the computer already find the drivers available for it, and then it asks for, then it tells it to check for updates. So that's always keep bear it in mind. When you install a new Wi-Fi card or whatever, always check to see if there's updates, because sometimes Windows got an update for it. So you never know. So I'm not gonna wait for it to do this Windows update right here, but you already get the point. So far, I like it. I'm impressed with it. And we just see what happens in the next couple of days. All right, y'all, I forgot to do an update on the speed test. So let's get back into it. So here we go. This is with the new Intel Wi-Fi 6E AX2010. Let's see what we got. Dang, that's sweet. That is sweet. Low looking sweet. Low looking sweet. I like what I see. I'm impressed. So I see over almost, let me see, almost 200% increase. Or if my math is wrong, you can correct me. So this is your boy JC. Let me get out of here. This is your boy JC. I appreciate you guys tuning into this installation of the Wi-Fi 6 card. I'm gonna be doing some before and after speed tests, so look out for those. And thank you guys for tuning in, and I hope to see you in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe and like the channels and leave your comments. And also, just a side note, whenever you see an ad, if it's for 30 seconds, at least watch it for the whole 30 seconds, because as a small YouTuber, we don't get paid much. Like me, I don't get paid nothing. But even if I watch a 30-second ad, I'll probably get a penny. So this will help me out, all right? Thank you guys for tuning in again, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace out.